live stream. We got a lot of questions this week pertaining to whether or not you can play music on your live streams, be it Instagram or TikTok, YouTube, Facebook. So we're actually going to go ahead and we are going to break this down because this is something incredibly important to talk about because most people are violating not only the law, but also the terms and service of these social media marketing providers. So we need to really break this down and chat a little bit about this. Can you play music on your live streams? The simple answer is no, you cannot play music on your live streams unless you have licensed that music. So when it comes to this, you need to be paying for the rights to use that music. Now you have to be aware, a lot of these social media platforms will actually take your live stream down first and ask questions later. So if you are playing music, even if you have licensed it, there's a very good likelihood that they are going to stop your broadcast mid-broadcast and ask questions later. Actually, probably not so much ask questions. You'll have to defend yourself against it, at which point you can say, yes, I have licensed this song, but the damage has already been done. Your live stream has been taken down. Now, not all the platforms are as quick to jump on this as like Facebook or YouTube, but that doesn't mean that you can still do it. So when you are playing this music, you can be given strikes. You can even be banned from the platforms, which is not a good situation. So on something like YouTube or Facebook or Instagram, if they hear that copyrighted music, they will stop what is going on. They'll take your live stream down. They'll give you a strike. If you get too many of them, you'll get banned from the platform. So you have to be aware of this. Now, there are certain situations where you cannot necessarily stop this. I understand that if you are out at a coffee shop and it's in the background, it's not something you can necessarily control. And they do take some of that into consideration, but you also have to be smart enough to not be broadcasting from places where you could be picking up things that could get you in trouble. So with copyrighted music, you have to make sure you have paid for the license. And there are such things as royalty-free, where you are gifted that license, where you don't have to pay for it, but you can use it, and they are giving you the rights to use it. So you always need to make sure you have documentation to back that up, because you cannot just use any song that you feel like to promote your business or even just to have as music in the background of what you are doing, whether it's a video or a live stream. All of it boils down to you have to have the proper permission, because if you don't have the proper permission, that is stealing from the artist. So think of it this way. If you are running a business, whatever it happens to be, how would you feel if somebody took your product or your service and then used it for their business? I'm a writer, so I would hate if somebody took my book and used it in their business. That's not okay. I'm a web designer. I would hate if somebody stole my website and used it for their business. I would not like if somebody took my YouTube videos where I'm teaching you different strategies and used it to teach their students in their business. You never, ever, ever take somebody's product or service and use it to do something in yours without proper permission. So you have to make sure that you have actually attained that special permission from people. So on live streams, you cannot play music. Even if you are doing like a cover of something, if you're playing it on your own, it still counts toward that licensing. So you have to make sure that you have that license covered, and you have to make sure you're reading the terms of service of the different social media platforms, because if you don't, you could get in trouble. You can be in violation of those terms and services and result in getting kicked from the platform. So if you can't be using music, you need to make sure you're doing something to engage them. So let's talk about what to do instead. And this particularly pertains to people who are, especially on TikTok, doing the get ready with me. So I know a lot of people like to jump on and they like to just have people around while they are doing their hair and makeup or while they're writing a book or whatever it happens to be. You tend to have a lot of dead air. Well, that's why they put music on so other people can listen to that and not be so bored. You actually cannot do that. This is against all of the terms of service. It is illegal. You cannot do it. So you need to learn to be more engaging. You have to do something that's going to get people's attention and keep their attention. So right now you're watching a live stream of me and I am speaking the entire time. I'm telling you what's going on. I'm educating you. I am making sure that I am entertaining you. and I don't have music going on. You're still listening to me. You're still engaged with me. And I go live multiple times a week for hours at a time to talk to my people, even while I'm working on things and doing other things. So when you go on a live stream, make sure you have something meaningful to say. If you don't have something meaningful to say, there's no point in you being on the live stream. If you just want company while you are getting ready or you are doing something, go FaceTime a friend, have a conversation with somebody, or do something somewhere else, but don't live stream. That doesn't add value to your people's the people who are viewing you. It doesn't add value to their life. You're not doing anything for them. So have something meaningful to say. You can either explain the process of what you're doing, or you can educate in some way. So if you are doing a Get Ready With Me video, you want to make sure that you are explaining what you're doing to your face as you are putting on your makeup and why it's meaningful, why it helps them, or how to do it. I do live stream book cover creations every single week, and I talk about the tools I'm using in Photoshop and why I'm doing these things and why I have tried to do these different types of things. So you want to make sure that you are explaining the process, explaining what you are doing, explaining what you are going through, and really have those conversations with them. And you can take questions while you're on air, but you cannot be playing that music. So you have to fill the time. You have to be the creative force here. If you are not going to go on air and do something meaningful, do not bother. Go FaceTime a friend. It's going to work out way better for you. So make sure you've got something meaningful that you can discuss while you are on air. Only stay on long enough to actually have those conversations. Do not have that dead air sitting there, because you're going to lose all of your viewers, which will tank your ratings in the algorithm system, which means less of your content will be seen. So don't do that. Now, remember, you can license music and use it on live streams. That is absolutely something you can do. It is in the terms of service, but there are specific ways that you have to do it. So you're going to have to look up how to do that. And you're going to want to get your account whitelisted for that, because otherwise, if they hear the music, they will kick you off of that live stream. So you need to license it in advance, have the proper documentation, and be aware, if you don't get yourself whitelisted in advance, there's a very good chance, even if you have licensed that music or it is your own music that you're playing on air, there's still a very good chance you will get kicked off and you'll have to explain yourself later. And then hopefully in the future they won't do it, but they very well may, and I've seen this happen over and over and over again, kick you off of that live stream. So you want to make sure that you are taking really good care of yourself and your accounts when you're doing this. And I've got a little pro tip for you. If you are licensing music, there are a couple of different places that you can be licensing it from, and I've got a special bonus for all of you. I use a really cool platform called Epidemic Sound, and I've got a 30-day free trial for you. So if you are someone who is using music for your videos or for your live streaming, you can actually get yourself whitelisted in the system so that it's not going to flag you as a copyright infringement, and you do not have to worry about this. So you can just go to music.kmrobinson.com. That'll kick you over to where you can sign up. It's a 30-day free trial, and you can check that out right now if that's something that you want. I'll link that down below in the show notes for you as well. But it's a really great thing to actually jump in and test out, see if it works for you and works on your live streams as well and in your videos. And they don't limit how many songs you can use per month. You just pay monthly, which is really cool, or less for an annual if you want, after your 30-day free trial. So you can check that out. Definitely something I recommend. But you want to make sure that as you are live streaming, you are the creative force here, and that you have content and conversation to have while you are on that live stream, and you are not using music while you are on a live stream, because 99.99999% of the time you will get in big trouble for it. And if you are illegally using that, even if you're playing the radio in the background, you can get sued. Like hardcore sued. Do not put yourself in that situation, and do not risk your business or your brand because you didn't have the ability to speak during a live stream, rather than just rely on someone else's work to carry you through it. So you've got to make sure that you are making effort to jump into your live streams in a meaningful capacity. And if you can't, go FaceTime a friend. It's going to be way better than potentially risking your business for this. And make sure you've got your licensing at any point where you are using music inside of your videos. As always, we are taking your questions and answering them here live on air. So feel free to drop your questions into the comment box. I'm going to be saving them. I'm actually testing something out here on the channel where I'm mixing up how I do these Q&As. And I am going to be answering more of your questions over in the community tab on a daily basis, and then using this live stream for the next couple of weeks to focus on one single question to really build that out for you instead of answering like 10 different questions at once. So we're going to see how this works. Go ahead and drop your questions, your comments, and what you need to do to grow on social media into the comment box down below, and we will get as many answered as possible over the next couple of days in the community tab, and I'll save the most popular ones for next week's live stream as we see how this process works for us. Thank you all so much for joining. As always, you can come hang out at kmrobinson.com, socialmediaforbosses.com, and drop your questions on any of the social platforms. Email me or drop them on any of my YouTube videos for answering later on this week. Thank you.